Hello everyone, I'm Priyanka Shine. Welcome to my YouTube channel, Mathalite. In this video, we'll continue with exercise 7A from chapter Ratio and Proportion. Coming to question number 26. If x plus 3 is to 4x plus 1 is the duplicate ratio of 3 is to 5, find the value of x. Read the question very carefully, students. They have told that x plus 3 is to 4x plus 1 is the duplicate ratio of this. So we have to duplicate this. What do you mean by duplicate ratio? You are going to square it. Okay, multiplying by the same ratio. So you have to square this, and square of this ratio is equal to this, because this is the duplicate of this. So you have to duplicate this ratio, not this one. Some of you might make the mistake of duplicating this. No, you have to duplicate this. So iska square is equal to this. Okay, so let's start solving. Write down the statement first. X plus 3 is to 4x plus 1 is the duplicate ratio of 3 is to 5. So this means this, that is x plus 3 upon 4x plus 1, is equal to square of this ratio. So 3 is to 5 is nothing but 3 upon 5, so you have to square it. Okay, so now solve this. X plus 3 upon 4x plus 1, keep the brackets as it is. 3 ka square 9, 5 ka square 25. Cross multiply. Okay, so 25 into x plus 3 is equal to 9 into 4x plus 1. We have to find the value of x. Okay, opening the brackets, 25 into x gives 25x, 25 into 3 is 75. 9 4s are 36 into x plus 9. So shifting 25x over here and 9 over here. So 75 minus 9 ho jayega, and 36x minus 25x. Okay. So 75 minus 9 will give 66. And over here we'll get 11x. So x is equal to 66 upon 11, 11 sigza. So 6 is equal to x, that is x is equal to 6. Okay, so very easy question. Let's read the next question, question number 27. If m is to n is the duplicate ratio of m plus x is to n plus x, show that x square is equal to mn. M is to n is the duplicate ratio of this. So this is equal to square of this ratio. Okay, duplicate ratio of this. Isko duplicate karna hai. You have to duplicate this ratio, not this one. So whenever you're given sentence like this, the ratio that is written after duplicate ratio of, usko square karna hai. Okay, you will square this, not this, students. Okay, so this is equal to square of this ratio. All right, so let's solve. On solving, we have to prove that x square is equal to mn. Okay, so write down the given first. M is to n is the duplicate ratio of m plus x is to n plus x. Okay, so m is to n is nothing but m upon n is equal to duplicate of this. So m plus x upon n plus x, square it. Duplicate means squaring, that is multiplying by the same numerator and same denominator. Okay, so m upon n is equal to squaring this. Okay, so a plus b, the whole square ka formula apply karenge. Okay, so it will be a square plus 2 into a into b plus b square. Okay, same thing in denominator, It is of the form a plus b the whole square. So a square plus 2ab plus b square. Okay. Now cross multiply. You could have cross multiplied earlier only. Okay. I solved over here. So you cannot cancel out this because there is plus sign in between. Okay. So ye kuch bhi cancel nahi hoga. Now shifting this over here and this over here. Cross multiplying basically. So m into n square plus 2nx plus x square, put brackets, is equal to n into m square plus 2mx plus x square. Okay. Now open the brackets. Mn square plus 2mnx plus mx square. Okay. Opening the brackets. It is equal to m square n. I'm writing it in alphabetical order. All right. So it'll be 2mnx plus nx square. Okay. 2mnx, 2mnx cancel ho jayega. Okay. Now you're left with mn square plus mx square is equal to m square n plus nx square. Now यहाँ पे x square चाहिए, so x square वाला terms group it, okay? Shift it on one side and the remaining two terms on the other side, okay? So the ones without x square you will keep on one side and the ones with x square keep it on one side. So mx square, shifting nx square over here, minus nx square, and m square n as it is rahega, shift karenge isko, so it will become mn square minus mn square. Okay. Now we can take x square common, in bracket you are left with m minus n, theek hai, is equal to mn mn. I can take common, so mn common liya. Now there is m square n, so 1m and 1n went outside, you are left with 1m, so 1m will remain in the bracket. Minus mn went outside, 1n is remaining, so 1n. Now m minus n you can cancel out, okay? So you're left with x square is equal to mn. So hence proved. Okay, box this. Proceeding to next question, question number 28. If 3x minus 9 is to 5x plus 4 is the triplicate ratio of 3 is to 4, find the value of x. Similar to previous question, you are told that this is the triplicate ratio of this. So by now you know kisko triplicate karna hai. You have to triplicate this. Okay? Because isko triplicate karenge, then you will get this ratio. Okay, so this ratio is equal to cube of this ratio. Triplicate means cubing, duplicate means squaring. Okay, so you have to cube this ratio, then it is equal to this ratio. Okay, so let's solve. Write down the statement first. 3x minus 9 is to 5x plus 4 is the triplicate ratio of 3 is to 4. Okay. So this ratio, that is 3x minus 9 is to means upon 5x plus 4, put brackets, is equal to triplicate of this ratio. So that is cube of this ratio. So cubing both numerator and denominator. Okay. 3x minus 9 upon 5x plus 4. Put brackets. 3 ka cube. 3 threes are 9. 9 threes are 27. And 4 ka cube is 64. 4 fours are 16. 16 fours are 64. Okay. Cross multiply. So 64 into 3x minus 9 is equal to 27 into 5x plus 4. So 64 into 3, 3 4s are 12, 18 plus 1, 19. 192x minus 64 into 9. So 9 4s are 36. 9 6s are 54 plus 3, 57. 576. 27 into 5. 5 7s are 35. 5 2s are 10. 13. 135x plus 27 into 4. 4 7s are 28, 4 2s are 8 plus 2, 10, 108. Okay. So shifting x wala term over here, grouping x, x together and the numbers together. So 576 will become positive plus 108 as it is. 192x minus 135x. So 192 minus 135. So you have to borrow. 12 minus 5, 7. 8 minus 3, 5. So 57x is equal to 576 plus 108. This will give you 684. Okay. Divided by 57. All right. 57 ones are 57. 11 remains, 114. 57 twos are 114. So x is equal to 12. All right, box the value. Okay. Next question, question number 29. Find the ratio compounded of the reciprocal ratio of 15:28, the subduplicate ratio of 36:49, and the triplicate ratio of 5:4. There are three different ratios and we have to compound those three ratios. Students, what do you mean by compounding the three ratios? If you have three different ratios, let's say 1 upon 2, 3 upon 4, 5 upon 6. Compounding means multiplying the three ratios. Okay, so there can be 2, 3, 4, 10, n number of ratios. Okay, so compounding means multiplying the ratio. Okay, so find the ratio compounded of, so you have to compound certain amount of ratios. What are these ratios? The reciprocal ratio of this. So you have to find reciprocal ratio of this. Then the subduplicate ratio of this. So one ratio you will get from this, one ratio you will get from this, and the triplicate ratio of this. So you have to find the three ratios and then compound them, that is multiply them. Okay, so very easy based on the sums that we have solved so far. So it's not that tough. So the first ratio is the reciprocal ratio of 15:28. So the reciprocal ratio of 15:28. What do you mean by reciprocal ratio? Whatever the ratio is, you have to take reciprocal of that. So it basically becomes 28:15, but you have to show the working. So reciprocal of numerator, reciprocal of denominator. So it will be 1 upon 15, okay, is 2, that is divided by 1 upon 28. The ratio is actually like this, 15 upon 28. So what you are doing is 15 ka reciprocal lo, that is 1 upon 15, divided by 28 ka reciprocal, that is 1 upon 28. Okay, so it will give 1 upon 15, division ko multiplication karte hai, so it will become reciprocal. 1 upon 28 will become 28 upon 1. That is, I can write it as 28. Okay. So nothing is getting cancelled. 28 upon 15. Okay. So 20, keep it as it is. Is 2 baad mein likhenge. Last mein answer find karke. So we are getting this as 28 upon 15. Second ratio, the subduplicate ratio of this. Subduplicate is what? Duplicate is squaring. Subduplicate is square root. So you have to take square root of the ratio. Square root of numerator, square root of denominator. Okay. So the subduplicate ratio
ऑफ 36 इज टू 49 इज राइट डाउन 36 अपॉन 49 ओके स्क्वेयर रूट ओके सो स्क्वेयर रूट ऑफ 36 इज 6 स्क्वेयर रूट ऑफ 49 इज 7 सो वी गॉट 6 अपॉन 7 कीप इट एज इट इज ओके 6 इज टू 7 मत लिखो लास्ट में वी विल डू ऑल राइट सो सब डुप्लीकेट रेशियो वी गॉट थर्ड रेशियो द ट्रिप्लीकेट रेशियो ऑफ 5 इज टू 4 सो द ट्रिप्लीकेट रेशियो ऑफ 5 इज टू 4 वॉट इज ट्रिप्लीकेट मल्टीप्लाइंग 3 टाइम्स दैट इज क्यूब सो क्यूब ऑफ न्यूमरेटर क्यूब ऑफ डिनोमिनेटर ओके सो इट विल बी 5 क्यूब अपॉन 4 क्यूब और यू कैन राइट इट एज 5 इंटू 5 इंटू 5 अपॉन 4 इंटू 4 इंटू 4 ओके ट्रिप्लीकेटिंग सो 5 इंटू 5 इंटू 5 125 ओके 5 फाइव ज़ा 25 25 फाइव ज़ा 125 4 का क्यूब 64 4 फोर ज़ा 16 16 फोर ज़ा 64 You are supposed to know the cubes up to 30, okay? Cubes, cube root, square, square root, you are supposed to know up to 30, all right? So we found the three ratios. Now we have to compound these ratios. So that is we have to multiply these ratios, okay? So let's find out. So the compounded ratio will be this into this into this these are the three ratios that we got so 28 upon 15 into 6 upon 7 into 125 upon 64 okay let's see if anything is getting cancelled out 7 4 za 4 16 za 2 3 za 2 8 za 5 3 za 5 25 za So, 3, 3. We are left with 25 upon 8. So, 25 upon 8, that is nothing but 25 is to 8. So, this is the final answer. All right. Let's solve the next question, question number 30. There are two parts over here. Part A, if R square is equal to PQ, show that P is to Q is the duplicate ratio of P plus R is to Q plus R. Part B, if P minus X is to Q minus X, B the duplicate ratio of P is to Q, then show that 1 upon P plus 1 upon Q is equal to 1 upon X. First, we'll solve part A. We are given that R square is equal to PQ. R square is equal to PQ. This is given. Okay. We have to prove that P is to Q. That is P upon Q. What we have to prove, let us write down. P is to Q, that is P upon Q, is the duplicate ratio of P plus R is to Q plus R. This is the duplicate ratio of this. So which one you have to duplicate? This. This is already the duplicated ratio. It is a duplicate of this. So you have to duplicate this. That is square it. Duplicate means squaring. Triplicate means cubing. Okay. So you have to square this. So always keep in mind is the duplicate ratio of ke baad jo bhi aayega that you have to duplicate. Okay. So this you have to duplicate. So this is equal to duplicate of this. That is, you will square numerator and square denominator. Okay. So, this is what we have to prove. So, to prove this, you have to consider either LHS or RHS. So, over here, LHS is simplified. RHS consider karte hai. Okay. So, we'll consider RHS. This is the given. So, write down. Given is equal to this. To prove this and now proof. So, considering RHS, RHS is P plus R the whole squared upon Q plus R the whole squared. So, this is of the form A plus B the whole square, A plus B the whole square. Let's apply the formula. So, a square plus 2ab plus b square, right? Put brackets. Same thing over here. This is a, this is b. So a square plus 2ab plus b square.
Okay. Now, over here we have r square, r square. And you are given that r square is equal to pq. So, we will substitute pq, pq over here. Alright.
So, p square plus 2pr plus pq. And q square plus 2qr plus pq.
Now, check all the terms in numerator. P square, 2PR, PQ. P is there in each of them. So, let's take P common.
1P we can take out because there is 1P over here, 1P over here. Yahan pe square hai. So, 1P common liya.
P square hai, so 1P still remains in the bracket.
What else? 2R will remain and Q will remain.
Same thing in denominator. Q square plus 2QR plus PQ. So I can take Q common.
Q common liya. You're left with 1Q, 2R and P.
Now check the brackets. P plus 2R plus Q, Q plus 2R plus P. Just the positions are different. Okay. P is there over here and Q over here. So let's change it, let's rearrange the terms and rewrite the bracket.
So P plus 2R plus Q upon Q into P plus 2R plus Q. Now the brackets are identical. So I can cancel out the entire bracket.
Students, you cannot cancel out P, P, 2R, 2R, Q, Q. No. That is not allowed because there is plus sign in between. Whenever there is plus and minus sign in between, you cannot cancel out the terms in numerator and denominator. Okay? So, we are cancelling out the entire bracket. Alright? So, this and this you can cancel out because there is into sign in between here. Theek hai? So, you can cancel this out.
So, we are left with P upon Q.
This is the LHS. So, we proved
that RHS is equal to LHS.
Therefore, write down the final thing. Okay.
P upon Q is equal to whatever.
And the statement that P is to Q is the duplicate ratio of P plus R is to Q plus R. Okay. So, write that down, students, after you write this. Okay. I don't have enough space over here, so I'm not writing, but you have to write it in exams. Okay. Now, moving on to the second part of the question. So part B, if P minus X is to Q minus X be the duplicate ratio of P is to Q, then show that 1 upon P plus 1 upon Q is equal to 1 upon X. This is given to you. Okay. So P minus X is to Q minus X be the duplicate ratio of this. So which one you have to duplicate? This. Duplicating means squaring. So you have to square this, square of this is equal to this. Theek hai? So
write down the given. P minus X is to Q minus X is the duplicate ratio of P is to Q. And to prove, we have to prove this part. 1 upon P plus 1 upon Q is equal to 1 upon X.
Theek hai? Starting with the given. So, this is equal to square of this ratio. So, let's start with this.
P minus X upon Q minus X, put the brackets,
okay,
is equal to square of this ratio. So P upon Q, dono ko square karenge. Okay, now let's cross multiply. So Q square into P minus X is equal to P square into Q minus X. Opening the brackets, Q square into p will give pq square. I'm writing it in alphabetical order. Okay, so pq square minus q square x over here, p square q minus p square x.
Now we need x on another side. Okay, so what we will do, x wala terms we'll group together and the remaining terms we'll group together. So let's shift x wala terms on one side and rest of the terms on the other side. So I'll shift p square x over here. Okay, I'm making p square x positive and making minus q square x negative. Okay, so let this remain negative, let's make this positive. So p square x minus q square x, this one will remain as it is, and shifting this over here. Okay, I can take x common. So p square minus q square will remain in the bracket and x common. Over here, what can I take common? I can take p also common, q also common. So let's take pq both common. What will be, what is left inside the bracket? P and q, right? PQ bahar nikla, ek p reh gaya, and yahan pe pq nikal gaya, one q is left. Theek hai? Over here we have p square minus q square. This is nothing but a square minus b square. Students, you are supposed to be familiar with identities. Okay, a plus b the whole square, a minus b the whole square, a square minus b square, even the cube identities you're supposed to know. All right, so if in case you don't remember, please remember all the identities, refer to these, and then solve these questions. Okay, so over here we have p square minus q square, which is of the form a square minus b square. And what is a square minus b square? A minus b into a plus b. This you are supposed to know. Without this you will not be able to solve this. So it will be x into p minus q into p plus q, okay, which is equal to pq into p minus q. Write down over here, okay, reason likho yahan pe for splitting this. P square minus q square is equal to p minus q into p plus q. You have to give reasons for using identities. All right, so earlier also when we use the identities a plus b the whole square, you have to give reason, okay, because you are using the identities. So solving further, now over here and here, if you check, we have x into p minus q into p plus q and pq into p minus q. So p minus q, p minus q, I can cancel out. Okay, so we are left with x into p plus q is equal to pq. Right, I can cancel this out. All right, so we are left with this. Now what do we need? We need 1 upon p plus 1 upon q is equal to 1 upon x. So x ko kya karte hai, we need it in denominator. So let's shift x over here and let's shift pq over here. All right, always look at what you need to prove. You need to prove this. So according to that, arrange the terms. So x denominator mein chahiye, so let's shift this on the other side, it will go in denominator, and let's shift pq over here. So p plus q as it is upon pq, okay, is equal to 1 upon x. Now over here we need 1 upon p plus 1 upon q. How to get that? Over here we have p plus q upon pq. Now students, I can write this as p upon pq plus q upon pq. Basically I am just splitting the terms. Numerator ko main split kar sakti hun. Okay, if I have 2 plus 3 upon 6, okay, I can write it as 2 upon 6 plus 3 upon 6, right? Basically डिनोमिनेटर कॉमन होता है तो हम लोग कॉमन डिनोमिनेटर ले लेते हैं. ओके, सो इफ आई गो प्रीवियस स्टेप में बैक, देन आई कैन राइट इट लाइक दिस ऑल्सो. ठीक है, सेम लॉजिक यहाँ पे अप्लाई कर रहे हैं. दैट इज पी प्लस क्यू अपॉन पी क्यू, आई कैन री राइट इट एज पी अपॉन पी क्यू प्लस क्यू अपॉन पी क्यू. यू कैनॉट स्प्लिट द डिनोमिनेटर. ओके, डिनोमिनेटर में अगर ऐसे होता पी क्यू अपॉन पी प्लस क्यू, देन यू कैनॉट स्प्लिट, यू कैनॉट राइट इट एज पी क्यू अपॉन पी प्लस पी क्यू अपॉन क्यू. नहीं, दैट इज नॉट अलाउड. ऑल राइट, यू कैन स्प्लिट द न्यूमरेटर बट नॉट द डिनोमिनेटर. दैट इज द रूल इन मैथ्स. सो this is equal to 1 upon x, p p I can cancel out, q q I can cancel out, so here I am left with 1 upon q, here 1 upon p is equal to 1 upon x. I just need to rearrange the terms. I got it. Okay, so hence proved. Okay, so box this and write down the final thing. Okay.